How you doing? So, basically, I'm redoing my rant video because I feel bad for saying that I was gonna upload my rant video, but it got deleted, so I'm just, like, I'm redoing it. So, basically, right, we're gonna talk about Club KCON and how I almost died at Club KCON. Interesting. Okay, so, first of all, I just want to say that when I heard of Club KCON, I thought it was actually like a club. Like, I really thought there was going to be a nice little dancing area, a nice little bar to get some soda, get some drinks or whatever. Non-alcoholic because it was all ages and the event ended at like 9. But you know, like real cute or whatever, it was not like that. So, we're past the point that they check the bags, right? And when I walk in, I notice that this is not a dang club. Like, this is not the club. It is a stage and, like a pit area, like, where everyone's gonna be standing. So I'm sitting here like, this is a lie. Like, this is all a lie. And I'm running, like, I'm speed walking. My mom is behind me. I'm speed walking to get a good spot. I wasn't up in the front, but I tried to get a good spot, right? So, the music starts, right? The DJ comes out. Everything is cool. He's playing K-pop music. Okay, cool, right? I'm not even exaggerating. Like, 20 minutes into this event, I felt like I was gonna die. And I'm gonna tell you why I felt like I was gonna die. I almost got heat exhaustion, bitch. Alright, so I'm standing there, right? And I am very skinny. Like, you may or may not know this, but I am very petite, okay? I was lucky enough to stand between two curvaceous women. Okay, so I'm like this, right? And I'm just being squished like I'm a motherfucking sandwich. Like I'm the cream part of an Oreo, okay? But that's not what has me about to die. What has me about to die is not only the lack of circulation because the AC's on but a bitch can't feel it. It was the smell. The smell. Bitch. I have a very sensitive nose. So when I don't smell something that's good, my body reacts to it in a negative way, just like, you know, human nature, just like how I would expect anyone to react. But with me, like, I get nauseous. I get sick. Like, I get physically ill. So you take the fact that I haven't eaten or drank anything in hours, right? Plus the lack of AC and air circulation in the motherfucking area. Plus some stank ass bitches. And what do you get? Bitch, I almost died. I was on the verge of dying. Before Stray Kids even came out, before the first group even came out, like 20 seconds in, my legs was already, bitch, I was about to die. At this point, I am hanging on by like the little ounce of hope I have left to not just faint right there and get stepped on, okay? And the crazy thing is that I was looking at YouTube videos because I plan on going to the BTS concert, so everyone wants to talk about the pit and like heat exhaustion and how you need to drink water, you're gonna die. And I'm sitting here like, that's for a weak ass bitch. Like, I'm not weak. Like, me get heat exhaustion, almost pass out, me never. My body was like, yes, you. Of course you. You're the weakest link. Do you see that you are like, that you weigh like 2 pounds? Of course you. I really almost died. My mom was like two people in front of me, right? So I'm staring around the area, like I'm getting a little dizzy and I'm just here like, bitch, you can do this. Like, you can survive. No, the fuck you can't. So my mom finally looks at me and I'm just staring at her like, girl, I need to go. Like, I need to go right now. So I'm like, you can stay here. You can go along with me. All I know is that I need to find the exit. So my mom ends up going with me. I go towards like the end, not the end of the pit, but I go to like towards my right, and I'm like, you know what? There must be an exit there. I get to the end, right? And it turns out there's like a gate. And then I realize that we're all caged in here like some motherfucking zoo animals. That ain't a motherfucking exit. So I panic and I start yelling at my mom, not an exit, not an exit. And we just end up going like towards the end of the pit now. We're like, well, fuck it, we gotta get the hell out of here. So while I'm going towards the end of the pit, I actually found like this little area that nobody was standing on, and it was like still in the pit, but it had a more open area where I could feel the AC. Everything felt great, and I was like, you know what, we can stay right here. I don't even need to leave. So we were standing there, but like I was like, okay, you know that feeling you get where you know you would feel a lot better if you were to just like sit down for a little bit? Well, I had that gut feeling, and I really wanted to pop a squat. So I popped a squat right there on the floor, and I was just like, this is me now. Like, this is how I'm gonna be going through this event, because I'm really about to die. My mom keeps asking me if I'm okay, and I'm like, yeah, girl, I'm fine. Like, I'm just resting my head on my arm. So I guess the ambulance saw me, a worker from the ambulance saw me, and he approached me. And then I started getting nervous, and I was like, oh my God, what the heck? So he's asking if I'm okay, and I'm like, yeah, I'm fine. He was like, you know, if you don't feel well, like, I'll just carry you over the gate. And I'm like, yeah, I'm fine. I just need a little bit. But he did not think I was okay. So he was like, come over. And I'm like, excuse me? He done picked me up like I was a rag doll. Like just flung me over. And I'm like, okay, I guess we're doing this. So he tells me to go sit down on one of the seats that's laid out there for, I guess, whoever's gonna pass out and die. Honestly, that was the best thing that could have ever happened to me, because when I sat down on that chair, I literally felt like everything's gonna be okay. I felt so much better just by sitting down. Like, it was crazy. So, you know how I said that I was really skinny, right? Like, I'm skinny to the point where it looks like I haven't eaten in days, bitch. So, he comes back to me. He's like, are you okay? Like, are you fine? I'm like, yeah, I'm fine. And he asks me, like, if I'm eating. And I tell him, yeah, I eat. I just shit a lot, you know, it's something I'm going through or whatever. So, he's asking me, like, if I have any allergies and you know, all this stuff about, you know, my personal problems. He asked me for my ID. I'm like, okay, you know, but let me just cooperate. I don't want to give him a hard time, you know. He asked me for my social security number, and now that I'm thinking about it, that is a little weird. For anyone who's wondering, I did end up giving him my social security number because I panicked. But anyways, you know, I don't think he's gonna do anything with that information. But yeah, so I'm sitting there, and he's like, you know, whenever you feel better, just let me know, and I'll put you back into the pit. And I'm sitting there like, you know what, I really don't feel like I want to go back into the pit, because bitches is musty and it smells really bad and it's hot, and like, I just feel so good right now. But you know what? I knew Stray Kids was gonna come out, and I was like, you know what? Let me just get back into that pit, even though I'm really about to die. Like, I was really, like, I'm not even exaggerating with you right now. Like, I was really about to die. Like, yo. Honestly, if it wasn't for the smell, I would have been able to tolerate it. Like, I would have been fine. Because even though it was hot, like, I'm used to the heat. That isn't ever faze me or bother me, and every once in a while I could feel the air circulating. But yo, like oh my God, people just really smell. Like, are you kidding me right now? Like, how how are you gonna come to this event? You know we are about to see gods. Like, we are not about to see no normal ass like artists. We are going to see idols, bitch. Idols. And you came out here stanking. Stanking. Like you don't care. Like you don't got no hygiene. What is wrong with you? I also think that Club KCON should be handing out little baby water bottles, okay? Because where my 99 cent going? You know that 99 cent fee for the $20 for the 2 days? You know what? That all adds up. It was a lot of us, bitch. You could have taken the 99 cents per 2 KCON tickets, and that could have added up to a lot of cases of water, bitch. You expect me to pay $2.55 for some water, and I can't even stand in the pit while I was standing on. I gotta stay where all the food's at. Where my 99 cents go? Where my 99 cents going? Where my 99 cents going? So please, pass out some baby water bottles. And moral of the story is, if you're gonna go to an event like that, use your deodorant, bitch. You don't gotta be stinking because of you.